that we begin to understand what these defects of character really are. They are these natural instincts which have been warped and perverted and twisted out of shape by fear. So the first thing we're going to do then is we're going to be looking at our resentments. Now, there are four parts to the fourth step. Four parts. The first part is our resentment list. The second part is the list of our own wrongs and the harm we've done others. The third part is our fears list. And the fourth part is our sex inventory. First, resentments. Second, our wrongs. Third, our fears. Fourth, our sex inventory. Now, each of these four parts looks at a particular defect or several defects. Obviously, the first part, which is resentments, looks at resentments and fear. The second part looks at selfishness, dishonesty, and fear. The third part looks at fear, and the fourth part looks at selfishness and dishonesty. Okay? So that each of these four parts has very specific defects which it addresses. There are a couple of other things that come out of a proper fifth step, fourth step. Let's examine what they are. These five things will result from doing a proper fourth step. First, we will lose our resentments. They will be gone. The resentments we carried in here with us will be gone because in our fourth step and our fifth step we have the complete spiritual answer to resentments. We're going to pray for the people who harmed us, and we're going to ask God to make us willing to forgive. And by the time we finish our fourth step, the resentments will be gone. Second, we're going to commence to lose our fears. In our fourth step, our fears begin to fall from us. We begin to lose our fears. Third, we're going to have an ideal for our future sex life. That is, we're going to have an ideal for how we wish to conduct ourselves in our relationships. And by extension, that goes not only to our sex relations, but to our relationships with all people. Fourth, we're going to have a list of all the people we've harmed. You may not realize it, but within the fourth step, we complete our eight-step list, with the exception of maybe one or two people that the fourth step doesn't dig out for us. But our basic eight-step list is done in the fourth step. Not only is the eight-step list done, but we have become willing and ready to make amends in our fourth step. So the basic aspects of the eight-step are already done in the fourth step. And number five, we're going to have a list of our defects of character. We're going to have especially the four cardinal defects: dishonesty, selfishness, resentment, and fear. They're going to all show up like a big neon signs and stereophonic widescreen Technicolor and Dolby. There'll be no doubt that they're right there in front of us. And so we're going to have that list of our defects, which we're going to carry with us into our fifth step. And it is in our fifth step that we're going to be admitting these defects and talking about the failures in our lives which led to these defects. Please open your books to page 65 now. Without getting into a lot of detail, let's think about this resentment list and what it is and why we need to do it. We've already discussed the fact that these resentments are killers. They're killers because they block us from God. And without God in our lives, we don't make it. But always remember, when you're working with your sponsees, keep going back to basics with them so that they understand what in the heck we're doing here. Without God in their lives, they don't recover. And so we must find our resentments, and we must deal with them. Now, what about resentments? What in the world are we talking about? If we look it up in the dictionary, we don't get much help. But there is a very simple definition that resentments are long-term anger. They are anger which persists. It may be that the persistence of this anger is no more than for a few days or even for a few hours. Resentment would not be something where we have a flash of anger and then it goes away. Many resentments your sponsees will have carried with them all of their lives. Some of these resentments are so well hidden that they're barely recognizable. Many times the resentments only surface as a matter of days.